So last class we have discussed about the motion and time. So in that we discussed about the several types of motion and defined the several types of motions. Now in this class, what do you mean by slow and fast? So you know that while walking, you have seen some of the people will walk faster and some of them will walk slower, right? Or else, you are while roaming outside in road, you will see that some of vehicles will move very fast and some vehicles will move very slow, right? So that can be calculated by knowing the two quantities, right? So the how fast is moving that vehicle or how slow is moving that vehicle, that can be calculated by using the two quantities. So first quantity is distance traveled by an object. That means, so if you are moving from here to there, from school to your home, you know that how much distance is there from here to there. So that can be measured. So always we are going to measure the distance in terms of meter, and the time taken by the object to cover that distance. So how much time will take the object to cover that much distance from school to your home? So that time also we have to measure. So by knowing these two quantities, so we can calculate the how object moves faster or else slower, right? By these two quantities we can come to know about whether the object is moving faster or else the slower. So the measurement of time. So you all know that the time is very precious to us, right? If you are going somewhere, right? If you become late to reach the railway station, if you want, then what happens? The rail will miss. So you miss the train, right? If you are going by bus, if you went to bus stop for a minute late, so what happens? The bus will move from the station, bus station. So you are going to miss the bus. So time is very precious to us, right? So now here what? So in our ancestors, where time is measured by the sum of the phenomena, the people use the events or the phenomena which are repeated regularly to measure the time. So our ancestors, how they are going to measure the time is, so the phenomena or else the events that happens in nature, on that they are going to measure the time. So here what are our ancestor peoples will use the events. So what are the events is going on in nature and the phenomena, what type of phenomena the changes will take, so based on that they are going to measure the time, right? So here, for example, how they are going to measure the time. So first one is time interval between sunrise to sunset or to the next sunrise. So based on that, our ancestors will know the time. So the time interval between the sunrise and the sunset and to the next sunrise, on based on this, our ancestors comes to know about the time. And second thing is one full moon to the another full moon. Based on this also, they are going to know the days and time. And third thing is from one season to the another season. So right. So based on these events or these phenomena in nature, our ancestors are going to know about the time or measure the time. So these time intervals are not standard units of time. So these are the not standard units of time. Why? Because so these time intervals are long. So it will take long time to know. So these are not standard units of time. So these time interval changes from place to place and time to time. So here what happens? In some places sunrise will be early and in other places sunrise will be slower. So that's why, see here what happens, the time interval changes from place to place and time to time. So that's why this is not an accurate, we will not get accurate time. That's why these are not a standard interval of time, right? So next, based on the periodic nature of these phenomena, our ancestors peoples made some devices to measure the time. So based on these periodic nature, our ancestors made some devices to measure the time. So your periodic nature means what? The regularly changes happens in nature. By regularly changes happens by nature itself, those changes or those phenomena we call it as a periodic nature. So here they have made some devices to measure the time. So in that, first one is sundial. sand clock, that is hour clock, and water clock, etc. So these are the some devices our ancestors made by the to measure the time. So this
and the only I told you that so some of the clocks that our ancestors are used. So in that first one sand clock, right? Second one sundial, and another one is water clock. So these are the clocks that our ancestors are used to measure the time, to know the time.
These items you can see in the page number 197, right? So here, first thing, sundial was used for a long to measure the time. So here, what happens is sundial is a hour clock, so it will take long time to measure the time. So that's why it is a used for a long to measure hour time. So next thing is sand clocks were used by the Romans. So here the sand clocks were used by the Romans. So here how sand clock and sundials are used here that you can know here. So sundial is based on the fact that the length of the shadow produced by an object by changing with the time of the day. So here what happens, sundial is used or is based on the fact of the length of the shadow. So here what is the length of the shadow will show the time of the that day. So the length of the shadow caused by an object, so whatever by the object we are going to place in that sundial, so that length, depending on length, that we come to know about the time of that day. So here this is the sundial. Next thing, sand clock. Sand clock were based on the principle that a certain a fixed quantity of sand is passed through a narrow passage in a certain fixed amount, fixed time interval. So here sand clock is a small thing. So here it has a, in that sand clock it has a certain fixed amount or fixed quantity of sand will be there. So that is passed through a narrow passage, right? So by the help of the passage, so we can know the time. These are the two, sundial and the sand clock, are the method to measure the time. Next, the construction of clocks and watches become possible after discovery of the time taken by the pendulum to swing from one end to the another end is always constant. So how we have prepared or possible to prepare or discover a watch or the construct a clock. So by knowing the swing of a pendulum, that pendulum to swing from one end to the another end, that swing is constant. So you know that yesterday I told you that this is what a pendulum clock, it will swing. So depending on this, right, we have constructed the, so how much time, depending on that, how much time taken by the to move through and through motion of that pendulum, that we are going to, by the help of that we are going to construct the clock. So see here, this is a bob, or else we call it as a pendulum. So this movement is constant from one end to the another end. So based on this we have constructed the watch. Okay, in 1658, Huygens used a pendulum clock to measure the time. Right? So here he was the first person, that is in 1658, he used a pendulum clock to measure the time. Right? So the mechanical wristwatches that we wear, the watches were then developed by using a balance wheel in a place of pendulum. So in the place of pendulum, we are using a balanced wheel to make a mechanical wristwatches that we wear a daily watches that are a pendulum type of clock watches, right? That is, that in the place of pendulum, we are using the balanced wheel, right? So these are the construction of the watches, wristwatches. So in modern clocks, that modern clocks and the watches are based on the oscillation produced in a quartz crystal. So this is a quartz crystal, that how many oscillations that produced in a quartz crystal, depending on that the modern clock and the watches are made or developed. So next thing is unit of time. Already I have told you that time is always measured in terms of second. So that's why the standard unit of time is second. Always remember that the standard unit of the time is second. So that is denoted by the letter small s. Second is always denoted by the letter small s. So the bigger units of time are, so here some of the units on that terms, so we are going to measure the time. So the bigger unit of times are minute, that is min, hour, that is h, day, in terms of day also we are going to measure, in terms of year also we are going to measure the time, etc. So these are the some bigger units of time. So here we know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, right? So always 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds and 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, and 1 day is equal to 24 hours, right? 1 day is equal to 24 hours. So in a 1 hour, 60 minutes will be there. In a 1 year, 365 days. So 1 year is equal to 365 days. So these are the units, these are the some of the units of the time that we are going to measure, right? So we all know that Earth rotates itself on its own axis. To complete one rotation on its own on itself, it will take a 1 day, right? Also we know that Earth rotates around the sun, right? To complete one rotation around the sun, it will take a year, it means a 365 days, right? So these are the some of the units of the time, right? So now in this class we have discussed about the slow and fast of a vehicle or a spring motion, right? And the measurement of time also we have discussed, and the unit of time also we have discussed, right? The unit of time is second, right? I hope whatever I have taught in this class you understood, right? Have a nice, thank you, have a nice day.